and welcome to another episode of Sports on GSI. I'm Matthew Wong. Let's get the show started with highlights from your Vancouver Canucks this past week. The Canucks wrapped up their six-game road trip in Anaheim last Friday. Anaheim had a four-game cushion after Peter Holland scored his first NHL goal late in the second period. Saku Koivu scored the opener before Vancouver defenseman Aaron Rome got a major penalty and a game misconduct for a dangerous hit on Ducks rookie Devont Smith-Pelly, leading to two power play goals. But Yannick Hanskin would score two goals, and Kevin Bieksa added another for the Canucks, who just fell short in the finale of a six-game trip despite outshooting Anaheim 22-2 in the third period. Roberto Luongo stopped 15 shots before Corey Schneider played in the third period for the Vancouver Canucks. The team headed home to Vancouver feeling good about their final 20 minutes of this game. On Sunday, November 13th, the Canucks returned home to face John Tavares and the New York Islanders. Roberto Luongo was again the starting goaltender for this game, and he looked sharp, stopping 23 of the Islanders' 24 shots to give the Canucks a 4-1 victory. Most of the offense came from a rare source, as defenseman Aaron Rome scored a goal and had two assists to give him his first three-point game in his career. At this point, it gave Rome 5 points in the first four games of the regular season, which equaled his entire last season's totals when he had 5 points in 56 games. The other three goals were scored by Henrik Sedin, Cody Hodgson, and David Booth. The Canucks would have a two-day break before they faced their rivals, the Chicago Blackhawks, on Wednesday night. Backup Corey Schneider started between the pipes, subbing in for the injured Roberto Luongo, and we'll have more on that later. Goalie Eddie Lack was called up from the Chicago Wolves to back up Corey Schneider. The game remained scoreless in the first period, but Yannick Hansen would open the scoring at the 38-second mark of the second period. However, the Hawks would rally back, scoring two in the second to make it 2-1 after 40 minutes. But then the Blackhawks would take over the game late in the third period, scoring three goals in a four-minute span to give them the win 5-1. In Corey Schneider's four losses as a starter this year, the Canucks' offense have only contributed two goals in those four starts. And here's a look at the upcoming three games for your Vancouver Canucks. On November 20th at 6 p.m., the Canucks will play host to the Ottawa Senators. And then on November 23rd, the Canucks will travel to Colorado, playing the Colorado Avalanche. You can catch that game at 6:30 on Sportsnet. And then on November 25th, the Canucks will play in Phoenix against the Coyotes. You can catch the game on Sportsnet as well at 6 p.m. Now on to some further Canuck news. Canucks starting goaltender Roberto Luongo was apparently injured in his last start Sunday against the New York Islanders. The Canuck goalie chose to opt out of an optional skate Monday, saying that the rumors of an injury should stop as he is just taking a rest after a long road trip and three starts in 4 days. However, Luongo was absent for the practice on Tuesday, and Elaine Vigneault confirmed to the media that Luongo has an upper body injury and is listed as day-to-day. When Corey Schneider got the start on Wednesday night, Coach Vino said that Luongo's injury was nothing serious. Also, defenseman Keith Ballard was injured on a hit by Blackhawks enforcer Daniel Carcillo on Wednesday night and was reevaluated. He is out with a back injury and is out indefinitely. Mason Raymond also returned to the ice on Thursday morning with a practice with the Canucks and is now cleared for contact. Now on to some other NHL news. Last Saturday, in a game between the Buffalo Sabres and the Boston Bruins, Buffalo goaltender Ryan Miller collided with Boston forward Milan Lucic in a race for the puck. The hit was controversial as Ryan Miller was thrown on his back with his goalie mask knocked off his head while several Buffalo players went after Lucic. Miller eventually left the game and was later diagnosed with a concussion and whiplash. The next day, he met with the media and here's what he said.
Mr. standpoint, how do you feel?
Not going to really get into that. I just stuck around because I just want to say that a piece of shit I think Lucic is 50 pounds on me and runs me like that. It's unbelievable. Everyone in the city sees him as a big, tough, solid player. I respected him for how hard he played. That was gutless. Gutless. Piece of shit.
Lucic was given a minor penalty and no further supplemental discipline. The Bruins won that game 6-2. The NHL's general managers meeting were held in Toronto this past Tuesday. Topics discussed included the 1-3-1 defensive trap system, the realignment for teams next year, and new boarding rules and goalie collisions. The meeting concluded with the 1-3-1 trap system being monitored, but no further action will be taken yet. Realignment discussions are also going to continue the following month, but the Detroit Red Wings and the Columbus Blue Jackets have expressed an interest to move to the Eastern Conference so that the Winnipeg Jets may move to the West. Also, NHL disciplinarian Brendan Shanahan led the talks about goalie collisions. It was decided that no rule changes were to be made, but there was emphasis on keeping the goalie safe in the game. Rule 42.3 states that charging allows for a major penalty at the discretion of the official, based on the degree of violence on the check. Shanahan also stated that a major penalty on Lucic should have been called rather than a minor penalty. And let's take a look at the results from the CFL playoffs last Sunday. For the Western Conference semifinals, the Edmonton Eskimos defeated the Calgary Stampeders by a score of 33-19. And for the Eastern Conference semifinals, the Hamilton Tigercats beat the Montreal Alouettes 52-44 in a high-scoring game. So moving on to the Western Conference Finals, you can catch both of these games on November 20th on TSN on Sunday. And for the Western Conference Finals, you have the BC Lions playing the Edmonton Eskimos. And in the Eastern Conference, you have the Winnipeg Jets playing the Hamilton Tigercats for their final. Before we go today, we want to give you the top five goals in the NHL so far this season, according to NHL.com. In this game between the Pittsburgh Penguins and the Colorado Avalanche, Pittsburgh Penguins forward Evgeny Malkin makes a beautiful move through Colorado rookie Gabriel Landeskog's legs before finishing the goal while falling down. In the same game between the Penguins and the Avalanche, Matt Duchene answers Evgeny Malkin's goal with a brilliant move between his own legs and is scoring the goal past Marc-Andre Fleury. In this third clip between the Dallas Stars and the Columbus Blue Jackets, Jamie Benn scores a beautiful goal by dangling through four Blue Jackets before scoring the goal past goalie Steve Mason. And in a game between the Philadelphia Flyers and the Boston Bruins, Claude Giroux scores a beautiful goal by getting past Captain Dano Chara and scoring past a flying Tim Thomas. The game between the Tampa Bay Lightning and the Carolina Hurricanes, Jeff Skinner, last year's Rookie of the Year, scores a beautiful goal by keeping the puck on his stick and skating through three defenders before scoring a goal past Tampa Bay goalie Dwayne Williamson. And that wraps it up for us today. We hope you enjoyed those clips. There are many ways you can stay in touch with us. To watch the other shows on our GSI video network, go to youtube.com/thegsivn. You can stay connected with us on Facebook, on our Facebook page at facebook.com/gsi.vn. And you can follow us on Twitter at gsi_vn. Thank you for all of you joining us this week, and I hope you all have a good weekend. Goodbye.